And I answered and said, Who can understand, O Lord, thy goodness? For it is incomprehensible. Or who can search into thy compassions, which are infinite? Or who can understand thy intelligence? Or who is able to recount the thoughts of thy mind? Or who of those that are born can hope to come to those things, unless he is one to whom thou art merciful and gracious? Because, if assuredly thou didst not have compassion on man, those who are under thy right hand, they could not come to those things, but those who are in the numbers named can be called. But if, indeed, we who exist know wherefore we have come, and submit ourselves to him who brought us out of Egypt, we shall come again and remember those things which have passed, and shall rejoice regarding that which hath been. But if now we know not wherefore we have come, and recognize not the principate of him who brought us up out of Egypt, we shall come again and seek after those things which have been now, and be grieved with pain because of those things which have been fallen. And he answered and said unto me, Inasmuch as the revelation of this vision hath been interpreted to thee as thou besoughtest, hear the word of the Most High, that thou mayest know what is to befall thee after these things. For thou shalt surely depart from this earth, nevertheless not unto death, but thou shalt be preserved unto the consummation of the times. Go up therefore to the top of that mountain, and there shall pass before thee all the regions of that land, and the figure of the inhabited world, and the tops of the mountains, and the depths of the valleys, and the depths of the seas, and the number of the rivers, that thou mayest see what thou art leaving, and whither thou art going. Now this shall befall after 40 days. Go now, therefore, during these days, and instruct the people so far as thou art able, that they may learn so as not to die at the last times, but may learn in order that they may live at the last times. And I, Baruch, went thence, and came to the people, and assembled them together from the greatest to the least, and said unto them, Hear ye, children of Israel, behold, how many ye are who remain of the 12 tribes of Israel. For to you and to your fathers the Lord gave a law more excellent than to all peoples. And because your brethren transgressed the commandments of the Most High, he brought vengeance upon you and upon them. And he spared not the former, and the latter also he gave into captivity, and left not a residue of them. And behold, ye are here with me. If therefore ye direct your ways aright, you also shall not depart as your brethren departed, but they shall come to you. For he is merciful whom ye worship, and he is gracious in whom ye hope, and he is true, so that he shall do you good and not evil. Have ye not seen here what hath befallen Zion? Or do ye, perchance, think that the place hath sinned, and that on this account it was overthrown, or that the land had wrought foolishness, and that therefore it was delivered up? And know ye not that on account of you who did sin, that which sinned not was overthrown, and on account of those who wrought wickedly, that which wrought not foolishness was delivered up to its enemies? And the whole people answered and said unto me, So far as we can recall the good things which the Mighty One hath done unto us, we do recall them, and those things which we do not remember, he in his mercy knoweth. Nevertheless, do this for us, thy people. Write also to our brethren in Babylon an epistle of doctrine, and a scroll of hope, that thou mayest confirm them also before thou dost depart from us. For the shepherds of Israel have perished, and the lamps which gave light are extinguished, and the mountains have withheld their stream whence we used to drink, and we are left in the darkness, and amid the trees of the forest, and the thirst of the wilderness. And I answered and said unto them, Shepherds and lamps and fountains came from the law, and though we depart, yet the law abideth. If, therefore, ye have respect to the law, and are intent upon wisdom, a lamp shall not be wanting, and a shepherd shall not fail, and a fountain shall not dry up. Nevertheless, as ye said unto me, I will write also unto your brethren in Babylon, and I will send by means of men, and I'll write in like manner to the 9 tribes and a half, and send by means of a bird. And it came to pass, on the 1 and the 20th day in the 8th month that I, Baruch, came and sat down under the oak, under the shadow of the branches, and no man was with me, but I was alone. And I wrote these two epistles. One I sent by an eagle to the 9.5 tribes, and the other I sent to those that were at Babylon by means of 3 men. And I called the eagle and spake these words unto it. The Most High hath made thee that thou shouldest be higher than all birds. And now go, and tarry not in any place, nor enter a nest, nor settle upon any tree, till thou hast passed over the breadth of the many waters of the river Euphrates, and hast gone to the people that dwell there, and cast down to them this epistle. Remember, moreover, that at the time of the deluge, Noah received from the dove the fruit of the olive, when he sent it forth from the ark. Yea, also the ravens ministered to Elijah, bearing him food, as they had been commanded. And Solomon also, at the time of his kingdom, whithersoever he wished to send or seek for anything, commanded a bird to go thither, and it obeyed him as he commanded it. And now let it not weary thee, and turn not to the right hand nor to the left, but fly and go by a direct way, that thou mayest preserve the command of the Mighty One, according as I said unto thee. These are the words of that epistle which Baruch the son of Neriah sent to the 9.5 tribes which were across the river Euphrates, in which these things were written. Thus saith Baruch the son of Neriah to the brethren carried into captivity, mercy and peace. I bear in my mind, my brethren, the love of him who created us, who loved us from of old, and never hated us, but above all, educated us. And truly I know that, behold, all we, the 12 tribes, are bound by one bond, inasmuch as we are born from one father. Wherefore I have been the more careful to leave you the words of this epistle before I die, that ye may be comforted regarding the evils which have come upon you, and that ye may be grieved also regarding the evil that hath befallen your brethren. And again also, that ye may justify his judgment, which he hath decreed against you, that ye should be carried away captive. For what ye have suffered is disproportioned to what ye have done, in order that, at the last times, ye may be found worthy of your fathers. Therefore, if ye considered that ye now suffered those things for your good, that ye may not finally be condemned and tormented, then ye shall receive eternal hope, if, above all, ye destroy from your heart vain error, on account of which ye departed hence. For if ye so do these things, he will continually remember you, he who always promised on your behalf to those who were more excellent than we, that he will never forget nor forsake us, but with much mercy will gather together again those who were dispersed. Now, my brethren, learn first what befall Zion, how that Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, came up unto us. For we have sinned against him who made us, and we have not kept the commandments which he commanded us, yet he hath not chastened us as we deserved. For what befell you, we also suffer in a preeminent degree, for it befell us also. And now, my brethren, I make known unto you that when the enemy had surrounded the city, the angels of the Most High were sent, and they overthrew the fortifications of the strong wall, and they destroyed the firm iron corners, which could not be rooted out. Nevertheless, they hid all the vessels of the sanctuary, lest the enemy should get possession of them. And when they had done these things, they delivered thereupon to the enemy the overthrown wall, and the plundered house, and the burnt temple, and the people who were overcome because they were delivered up, lest the enemy should boast and say, thus by force we have been able to lay waste even the house of the Most High in war. Your brethren also they have bound and led away to Babylon, and have caused them to dwell there. But ye have been left here, being very few. This is the tribulation about which I wrote to you. For assuredly I know that the consolation of the inhabitants of Zion consoleth you, so far as ye know that it was prospered. Your consolation was greater than the tribulation which ye endured in having departed from it. But regarding consolation, hear ye the word. For I was mourning regarding Zion, and I prayed for mercy from the Most High, and I said, how long will these things endure for us? And will these evils come upon us always? And the Mighty One did according to the multitude of His mercies, and the Most High according to the greatness of His compassion. And He revealed unto me the word, that I might receive consolation. And He showed me visions, that I should not again endure anguish. And He made known to me the mystery of the times, and the advent of the hours He showed me. Therefore, my brethren, I have written to you, that ye may comfort yourselves regarding the multitude of your tribulations. For know ye that our Maker will assuredly avenge us on all our enemies, according to all that they have done to us. Also, that the consummation which the Most High will make is very high, and His mercy that is coming, and the consummation of His judgment is by no means far off. For lo, we see now the multitude of the prosperity of the Gentiles, though they act impiously, but they shall be like a vapor. And we behold the multitude of their power, though they do act wickedly, but they shall be made like unto a drop. And we see the firmness of their might, though they resist the Mighty One every hour, but they shall be accounted as spittle. And we consider the glory of their greatness, though they do not keep the statutes of the Most High, but as smoke shall they pass away. And we meditate on the beauty of their gracefulness, though they have to do with pollutions, but as grass that withers shall they fade away. And we consider the strength of their cruelty, though they remember not the end thereof, but as a wave that passeth shall they be broken. And we remark the boastfulness of their might, though they deny the beneficence of God, who gave it to them. But they shall pass away as a passing cloud. For the Most High shall assuredly hasten His times, and He shall assuredly bring on His hours, and He shall assuredly judge those who are in His world, and He shall visit in truth all things by means of all their wicked works, and He shall assuredly examine the secret thoughts, and that which is laid up in the secret chambers of all the members of man, and He shall make them manifest in the presence of all with reproof. Let none, therefore, of these present things ascend into your hearts, but above all, let us be expectant, because that which is promised to us shall come. And let us not now look unto the delights of the Gentiles in the present, but let us remember what He has promised to us in the end. For the ends of the times and of the seasons and whatsoever is with them shall assuredly pass by together. The consummation, moreover, of the age shall then show the great might of its ruler, when all things come to judgment. Do ye, therefore, prepare your hearts for that which before ye believed, lest ye come to be in bondage in both worlds, so that ye be led away captive here, and be tormented there. For as to that which existeth now, or hath passed away, or which is to come, in all these things, neither is the evil fully evil, nor again the good fully good. For all healthiness of this time are turning into diseases, and all might of this time is turning into weakness, and all the force of this time is turning into impotence, and every energy of youth is turning into old age and consummation, and every beauty of gracefulness of this time is turning faded and hateful, and every proud dominion of the present is turning into humiliation and shame, and every praise of the glory of this time is turning into the shame of silence, and every vain splendor and insolence of this time is turning into voiceless ruin, and every delight and joy of this time is turning into worms and corruption. And every clamor of the pride of this time is turning into dust and stillness, and every possession of riches of this time is being turned into Sheol alone, and all the rapine of passion of this time is turning into involuntary death, and every passion of the lusts of this time is turning into a judgment of torment, and every artifice and craftiness of this time is turning into a proof of the truth, and every sweetness of unguents of this time is turning into judgment and condemnation, and every love of lying is turning to contumely through truth. Since, therefore, all these things are done now, doth anyone think that they will not be avenged? But the consummation of all things shall come to the truth. Behold, I have therefore made known unto you these things whilst I live. For I said that ye should learn the things that are excellent. for the Mighty One hath commanded to instruct you. And I will set before you some of the commandments of his judgment before I die. Remember that formerly Moses assuredly called heaven and earth to witness against you and said, If ye transgress the law, ye shall be dispersed, but if ye keep it, ye shall be kept. And other things also he used to say unto you when ye, the 12 tribes, were together in the desert. And after his death, ye cast them away from you. On this account there came upon you what had been predicted. And now Moses used to tell you before they befell you, and lo, they have befallen you, for you have forsaken the law. Lo, I also say unto you after ye have suffered, that if ye obey those things which have been said unto you, ye shall receive from the Mighty One whatsoever hath been laid up and reserved for you. Moreover, let this epistle be for a testimony between me and you, that ye may remember the commandments of the Mighty One, and that also there may be to me a defense in the presence of him who sent me. And remember ye the law and Zion, and the Holy Land, and your brethren, and the covenant of your fathers, and forget not the festivals and the Sabbaths. And deliver ye this epistle and the traditions of the law to your sons after you, as also your fathers delivered them to you. And at all times make your request perseveringly, and pray diligently with your whole heart, that the Mighty One may be reconciled to you, and that he may not reckon the multitude of your sins, but remember the rectitude of your fathers. For if he judge us not according to the multitude of his mercies, woe unto all of us who are born. Know ye moreover that in former times, and in the generations of old, those our fathers had helpers, righteous men and holy prophets. Nay, more, we were in our own land, and they helped us when we sinned, and they interceded for us to him who made us. Because they trusted in their works, and the Mighty One heard their prayer and forgave us. But now the righteous have been gathered, and the prophets have fallen asleep, and we also have gone forth from the land, and Zion hath been taken from us. And we have nothing now save the Mighty One and his law. If therefore we direct and dispose our hearts, we shall receive everything that we lost, and much better things than we lost by many times. For what we have lost was subject to corruption, and what we shall receive shall not be corruptible. Moreover, also, I have written thus to our brethren to Babylon, that to them also I may attest these very things. And let all those things aforesaid be always before your eyes, because we are still in the spirit and the power of our liberty. Again, moreover, the Most High also is long-suffering toward us here, and he hath shown to us that which is to be, and hath not concealed from us what shall befall in the end. Before, therefore, judgment exacts its own, and truth that which is due, let us prepare our soul, that we may enter into possession of and not be taken possession of, that we may hope and not be put to shame, and that we may rest with our fathers and not be tormented with our enemies. For the youth of the world is past, and the strength of the creation is already exhausted, and the advent of the times is very short. Yea, they have passed by, and the pitcher is near to the cistern, and the ship to the port, and the course of the journey to the city, and life to its consummation. And again, prepare your souls, so that when ye sail and ascend from the ship, ye may have rest, and not be condemned when ye depart. For lo, when the Most High shall bring to pass all these things, there shall not be again a place of repentance, nor a limit to the times, nor a duration for the hours, nor a change of ways, nor place for prayer, nor sending of petitions, nor receiving of knowledge, nor giving of love, nor place of repentance for the soul, nor supplication for offenses, nor intercession of the fathers, nor prayer of the prophets, nor help of the righteous. There is the sentence of corruption, the way of fire, and the path which bringeth to Gehenna. On this account there is one law by one age, and an end for all who are in it. Then he will preserve those whom he can forgive, and at the same time destroy those who are polluted with sins. When therefore ye receive this my epistle, read it in your congregations with care, and meditate thereon, above all on the days of your fasts, and bear in mind, by means of this epistle, as I also bear you in mind in it, and always fare ye well. And it came to pass, when I had ended all the words of this epistle, and had written it sedulously to its close, that I folded it, and sealed it carefully, and bound it to the neck of the eagle, and dismissed and sent it. Here endeth the book of Baruch, the son of Neriah.